The climber awakens to a beautiful day in the canyon and the final day on wall. The view is spectacular from the portalage as the climber rests. Early in the morning, the California condors appear once again, swooping within 10 feet of the climber, then rising and landing on the canyon rim a mere 10 feet from the camera crew. These magnificent and endangered birds are each numbered. These two birds, numbers 36 and 99, are two of only about 125 alive in the wild. In 1987, there were only 27 California condors remaining in the world. They were very curious about what we were doing. What a special treat to be their guest in this wilderness. The solo system for climbing requires the climber to anchor the rope at the bottom of each pitch and feed the rope through an auto-locking belay device as he ascends the rock. He places removable hardware into small cracks in the rock to help protect him if he were to fall. Soloing requires the climber to lead up a pitch, rappel back down, unhook the haul bag from the anchor, ascend the rope while removing all of the climbing hardware that was placed on lead. Once back at the high point, the climber then sets to the grueling task of pulling up the haul bag. The climb has been awesome, a great success. As we crossed the Virgin River, we entered into a wilderness that needs our continued protection and advocacy. Our green spaces need our help. How can we expect the next generation to save and care for our environment if they never experience it? We hope that by joining the climber and crew on this climb, you have a deeper appreciation for our natural world and the need to connect children to it through direct experiences. Progressing through the final overhanging pitch to the summit, the climber and crew reflect on the past few days. We ask, what are you going to do to help save and protect our natural world today and in the future?